Hey everyone, in this video we will discuss the Quick Insights feature for Power BI service. So essentially Quick Insights lets us get quick insights on our data set. And the reason we might be using this feature is, let's say that we've got a really new data set and we don't have too much clue as to what are the data elements and how the data stitches together. So we could run algorithms which Microsoft provides to get insights on the data set. Another one is we want to quickly build a dashboard and we want some insights going into that dashboard, and we could probably run quick insights, get some visuals and create a nice dashboard. And it's also possible that you might have created a report or a dashboard and missed certain insights, and you can run the algorithms and see if there's something new which comes, you can come across. So you can probably use that as an insight as well and pin that visual to the dashboards. So essentially, when you click on Get Insights on your data set, it will generate a lot of visuals, like a report page of visuals. Around 32 visuals is the maximum that it gives you the capability to get insights on. And so let's start, and I'll just take you through some more stuff as we go along. I'm already logged into the Power BI service here, and I will go into, and I'll click on Learn to Excel. So this is one of the workspaces, and I'll go to the data set, and I'll click on My Reports. For My Reports, I'll just get insights on the data set. So when I click on the More Options, it says View Insights. So that's an option that is available to me. But you have to be aware that if you are using direct query or if you're using row level security in your report, this feature will be disabled for you at the moment, because this is not a direct query or it doesn't have row level security implemented, I'm able to get the insights. So I'll hit View Insights and see Microsoft has generated these insights for me. So if it is the first time you're running View Insights, it might take you slightly longer to generate the insights. And you can go through this, and let's say you like something, for example, maybe you like this visual, and you can click on the focus mode for one of the visuals. So if I, let's say, click on that, you can see on the right, it is also showing me the fiscal year and the sales amount. So I can go ahead and add more filters into, so let's say if I want to filter for maybe 2010 only or 2012 only, I could put that in and add that filter. Another thing you can do is you can see this Get Insights button, so you can generate related insights on your insights visual as well. So I can go here and click on Get Insights, and it generates another set of insights on this, so I can scroll through these as well. And for example, if let's just scroll through, and you can see that sales amount by English product category name, so bikes contribute the maximum. And similarly, so I could go ahead, and I like this insight, so what I'll do is I'll pin this to a dashboard. So I click on the pin button, existing dashboard, and I'll click on the sales dashboard and pin. So now I can go back to my, I can exit this mode, and I can go to my Learn to Excel workspace, and I can see my sales dashboard. And if I click on that and I go in and I scroll to the bottom, I can see this visual pinned in. So it's a very good feature. And just to recap, you essentially will reuse it if you're exploring a new data set and you're not sure about the insights, or you want to build a dashboard quickly, or you've missed some insights and you're looking for that missed insight which could complete your dashboard. So I hope you find this video useful, and thanks for watching this video.